99% of the failures come from people who have the habit of making excuses. So I want to talk about the four buts of why people don't do things. The four buts of why they don't chase their dreams. The four buts of why they don't chase their ambitions. Now, these aren't the only four. These are just four that I really want to talk about because I think that they're relevant to our lives. So the four buts, I'm going to list them off and then I'm going to talk about each. But I'm too busy. But I can't afford to. But my boss won't let me. And but I'm not a business person, a writer, etc. So the first one, but I'm too busy. I want to do this, but I'm too busy. How do we fix that? Sit down and we block out our time. Take a week or two, see where you're spending your time. You go to work from blank to blank. I get home, I work out from blank to blank. I eat from blank to blank. Lay it out and find time where you can chase your dreams and your ambitions. Find time where you can use that time to chase your dreams and do what it is you want to do. And if you can't find any time, look at what you're spending your time on and see where you can stop it. If you get home from work and you sit on the couch and you watch TV, nothing wrong with that for an hour, whatever it is. But if you want to chase something, you really want something, spending your time on the couch watching TV isn't going to help you chase your dreams. So maybe you can realize that, wow, I'm actually spending 2 hours a night on the couch watching TV. Try to drop that down to an hour and then use the other hour towards your dreams and then work on slowly getting rid of that so you can actually chase what it is you want to chase. There's always time. You can always find time. You just have to realize, where am I spending my time? I know I talked about that in a different episode, but that's a huge but. A lot of people say, I don't have time. I'm too busy. Number two, but I can't afford to. I want to start this company, but I can't afford to. I read a book called The $100 Startup, and that's actually the book that's recommended this week because it shows and it tells about people that have started six-figure companies with less than $100. Six-figure companies with less than $100. Now, I know maybe you don't have $100. Then you can find and pick up an extra shift, pick up an extra job so you can get that $100. And then you can use these companies that in the book, which will be linked in the description, so that you can figure out, wow, I can really start a six-figure income with $100. And you might not even get to six figures. You might only get to 40 grand, 50 grand, even 10 grand. But that's more than what you had before, right? And just for $100, that's a huge return on investment. But I can't afford to. You can't afford to. Maybe you should have to stop spending your money on coffee at Starbucks for a month. Or stop buying those clothes that you're trying to impress people with that don't even care if you're wearing them or not. Number three, but my boss won't let me. If your boss won't let you chase what you want to do, then one, he might not be the boss for you. But two, that might not be the right company. Or three, take off, and I read this in a book, take off paid time off, spend a day or a sick day, and spend that whole day chasing what you want to do, figuring out what it is you want to do. Because if your boss won't let you, then you got to find time and be proactive so that you can start something or you can do something that will maybe allow you to leave that job and leave that boss. And then number four, the last one, but I'm not a business person, a writer, etc. I want to start a company, but I'm not a business person. I didn't go to college for business. I want to start a blog, but I'm not a writer. I want to help people, but I don't have a psychology degree. Many, many stories out there where people haven't gone to college, people don't have those certain degrees, people don't know how to write or are not good writers, and they start these things. They start these companies, they start these blogs, they start all these things without having the previous experience. Why? Because having schooling in something is important. But if you can learn and you're willing to learn, then you can overcome that hurdle of not having that education and be successful. Joshua Metcalf, a person I actually interviewed on this podcast a while back, almost over a year ago, he speaks on mental toughness. He's a life coach. He didn't go to school for psychology. He just read a bunch of psychology books. He doesn't have the degree, but he took the time to read about them. So now he can coach people on them. So there's many, many stories out there where people don't have the background. They're not a business person. They're not a writer. They're not a psychology major. Through their willingness to learn, they have overcome that hurdle and been successful. So those four buts. But I'm too busy. But I can't afford to. And but my boss won't let me. but I'm not a business person, a writer, etc. 99% of the failures come from people who have the habit of making excuses. Instead of saying, I don't have time, I'm too busy, be proactive and see, why am I too busy? Why don't I have time? What am I wasting my time on? What I can't afford to? What am I spending money on for things I don't need, but my boss won't let me? I'm gonna take a day off, find myself, find what I really wanna do, or get my stuff done and then I can work on it. And number four, but I'm not a business person, a writer, or anything like that. Be proactive, take the time to learn, overcome that hurdle, because it's very, very possible.